I love that song. If I was to have my own national anthem, that would be it. First off, my name is Bruce. I do have ALS. And apparently, the words mean amyotrophic lateral sclerosis. Well, I'm a bit dyslexic. I have no idea what that means. So I give it my own meaning. ALS stands for always looking silly. That's good you're laughing, because that's what I'm all about too. That's my personality. First off, I'm going to start with Mark 12, 30 to 31. And you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, with all your strength. The second is this: you shall love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than this. I got to tell you, this church family's been loving on us amazingly. And I have to thank you, because we're a little behind in our thank you cards. So I just blanket statement for all your loving, your prayers, your gifts, your words of encouragement. It's been phenomenal. Part of the reason why I can still smile, even with this terrible disease, is partly my personality and partly what God's Word says. There was a book produced many years ago, and it was encouraged to be read by the Focus on the Family many years ago. And a personality book had basically four different types of personalities: sanguine, choleric, melancholy, and phlegmatic. Well, I'm 60% sanguine and 40% phlegmatic. Sanguines are kind of people. They go into a quiet room full of people and they got to say something silly to get the audience going, to get the people going. That's who I am. And I can prove that, because about a month and a half ago, I was in an elevator with 9 other people in the hospital. I said something stupid and the whole place cracked up. And 40% phlegmatic. Phlegmatics are people with very strong, serving-hearted people. I mean, a lot of the medical industry apparently has a lot of phlegmatics in it. But they're also known to be stubborn. That was my point to be made. I don't give up. You heard that song, Be an Overcomer. Don't give in, don't give up. That's me. Genesis 1, 26, 27. God said, let us make man in our own image, according to our likeness. Let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, over the birds of the air, and over the cattle, over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps on the earth. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them. Sorry, just a second. According to our likeness, God is a spirit being, and so are we. I did a rope illustration last time I was up here. And I strung a rope out, and on one little piece of the end was had a tape on it, and the rest of the rope was stretched out. It demonstrated eternity. The rope that was taped, that demonstrated our years of life on this earth. And it varies, obviously. But let's just say, averaged out about 80 years. But the rest of the rope represented eternity. We are made according to our likeness, as God said. He's a spirit being, we're spirit beings. I always look through that perspective when I read my Bible, whether I make decisions. I used to say when I was working in the industry, I used to say, I work for God, I don't work for anybody else. My boss can get the benefits of that, but I work for God. So I always had that perspective. But eternity, let's just read John 3:16 and 17. For God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. I accepted Christ on his terms. I accepted that I was born a sinner, that I sinned by choice. I asked him years ago to forgive me and asked him to be the Lord of my life. So when I go through my difficulties, I have that perspective that I'm going to a good place anyways. James 4:14. Yet you do not know what your life will be like tomorrow. You are just a vapor that appears for a little while and then vanishes away. That 80 years to us is forever until you get there and you look back and you say, where has time gone? But to God, it's just a small amount of time. And after that, it's eternity. John 14:1-3. Do not let your heart be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me, Jesus said. In my Father's house are many dwelling places. If it were not so, I would have told you. For I go to prepare a place for you. If I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also. It's an amazing promise. This is the day the Lord has made. We rejoice and be glad in it. There is no room for negativity there. I like that. But then again, I am extroverted. Matthew 11:28. Come to me, all you who are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. I rest on that rest. I dwell on those promises. I am not a quitter. I've been known to be called a tough nut. I love that song that was sang earlier. It describes me a little bit. I've lost my thoughts. I see myself as a soldier. There is evil in this world, and most diseases are probably influenced by satanic activity in a variety of ways. I'm not suggesting all are, but I've heard it said that Satan hates us something terrible because we are in the image of God, made in the image of God. And I see myself as a soldier who's been wounded, but not giving up. For me and my household, we will serve the Lord. I will not give up. I will not give in. Yes, my time is coming short, but I have lots to look forward to. When I go to heaven, I'm going to have a new body, and I'm going to look for Samson and offer him an arm wrestle. He humor is a good way to get by on things. I oftentimes try to make people laugh. That's who I am. I can't help it. Don't want to help it. It's fun for me. Just recently, I was at an ALS support group, and there was a lady there that said that her husband won't come because he's embarrassed, because he apparently drools a lot. And I said, oh man, I'm going to have to take one for the team. So I did my silly self. I got a wad of spit and let it drool down my chin. Everybody in the room cracked up, except Barb. She was grossed out. If I'm not here next week, it's because I embarrassed my wife and I'm going to get beat up. But anyway, the lady came to me afterwards and she said, thank you for doing that. I will tell my husband that you did that for him. I wasn't after that. I was just out to be funny. You heard the song earlier today, For Me and My House Will Serve the Lord. I love that song. There's just too many songs, too many verses that are appropriate for this time. But I got to get you guys out in time for Christian chicken, so I am going to leave it with that. Leave it at that. I can't tell you how much the Lord is in my life. And he's got his hands wrapped around me. I do not worry. I do not complain. I am totally relying on him. Totally, totally relying on him. I'm not depressed. I haven't been depressed. I don't even know what that means. I am bored. Let me tell you, I'm bored. I used to be a can-do kind of guy. At the age of 50, I worked alongside some guys in their 20s. I worked harder and faster just because I could. The guy said to me, one of the two of them said to me, why do you work so hard? Because I can. I have fun wherever I can. I'm going to leave you with that for now. I'm not very organized and I run out of notes. And I just want to thank you for the opportunity to share this with you and to thank you for loving on me and my family so much. We got prayers going from Sarnia to Ottawa, from St. Thomas to Sault Ste. Marie. And I can't tell you how much that excites me. We're constantly in the presence of the Lord with your prayers. If I was to say what you could pray for specifically is that I don't lose my voice, because that would really drive me nuts. My family might like the option. But that is something the ALS patients oftentimes do eventually lose, is their voice. And that would just drive me nuts if I couldn't at least talk. So you can pray for that. And pray for the stress for the family. They seem to be needing that as well. Again, thank you very much. I think I'll close with that.